Although World War I wouldn't end officially until June of 1919 at the Treaty of Versailles, a call to ceasefire known as Armistice Day was issued on the 11th hour of the 11th day of the 11th month, that being November 11 at 11 a.m. of 1918, which is what we now know as Veterans Day. This day marked the end of fighting of the Great World War I. In a statement he issued, Woodrow Wilson said this: "To us in America, the reflections of Armistice Day will be filled with solemn pride in the heroism of those who died in the country's service, and with gratitude for the victory, both because of the thing from which it has freed us, and because of the opportunity it has given America to show her sympathy with peace and justice in the councils of the nations." As you've probably heard it said, we are the land of the free because of the brave. So I'd like to give thanks on the behalf of many to the veterans who have served our country, those from Long Beach CRC, and I'm sorry if I miss any names, but I think of Adrian, and Art, and John, and David, and Thomas, and Tom, and Tom, and Dick, and Tim. We thank you for your service. We know that freedom is never free. Christians also celebrate a great deal of freedom, freedom that was earned for us in the same way. So by his sacrifice, Jesus Christ gave us freedom beyond just political freedom. We're going to look at that now. Jesus spoke about freedom often. In fact, as he opened his ministry in Luke chapter 4, we see him read from Isaiah as he talks about the freedom that he will give. Here's what it says. "He went to Nazareth, where he had been brought up, and on the Sabbath day he went into the synagogue, as was his custom. He stood up to read, and the scroll of the prophet Isaiah was handed to him. Unrolling it, he found the place where it is written, 'The Spirit of the Lord is on me, because he has anointed me to proclaim the good news to the poor. He has sent me to proclaim freedom for the prisoners and recovery of the sight for the blind, to set the oppressed free, to proclaim the year of the Lord's favor.'" So as the people hear Jesus read from Isaiah, they hear these words of freedom, and they probably expected that Jesus would be the sort of Messiah who would give Israel political freedom, that he would overthrow Rome, that he would assemble an army, that he would be a political hero. But Jesus had bigger things in mind. This wasn't the sort of freedom that he would bring. Let's look into Scripture to see the sorts of freedom that Jesus offered for us. Again, freedom is never free. Jesus paid for all of this by his sacrifice for us on the cross. One of the freedom we experience is a freedom from guilt. Let's look at Psalm 103, verse 12, where it says, "As far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us." So we have this sort of freedom that we don't have to live with the regrets of yesterday or last week or last month or last year. That he has forgiven our sins because of what he did on the cross, past, present, and future. And so each day we can live for him in perfect freedom, freedom of conscience. We don't have to walk around with his guilt anymore. And it wasn't just freedom from guilt. Jesus also gave us freedom from the law. Here's what it says in Galatians chapter 1. "It is for freedom that Christ has set us free. Stand firm then, and do not let yourselves be burdened again by a yoke of slavery. Mark my words, I, Paul, tell you that if you let yourselves be circumcised, Christ will be of no value to you at all. Again, I declare to every man who lets himself be circumcised that he is obligated to obey the whole law. You who are trying to be justified by the law have been alienated from Christ. You have fallen away from grace. For through the Spirit we eagerly await by faith a righteousness for which we hope. For in Christ Jesus neither circumcision nor uncircumcision has any value. The only thing that counts is faith expressing itself through love." So here we see this freedom, not from guilt this time, but freedom from the chains of the law. That Jesus Christ did what we couldn't do. He followed every little detail of the law. He jumped through those hoops. He checked off those boxes. Now we can live free by the Spirit, that we aren't burdened by the law, because of the grace given to us through Jesus Christ. But it wasn't just freedom from guilt, and it wasn't just freedom from the law. We also receive freedom from the shackles of sin. and from death itself. Here's what it says in Romans chapter 8. Therefore, there is now no condemnation for those who are in Christ Jesus, because through Christ Jesus, the law of the Spirit who gives life has set you free from the law of sin and death. For what the law was powerless to do because it was weakened by the flesh, God did by sending his own Son in the likeness of sinful flesh to be a sin offering. And so he condemned sin in the flesh in order that the righteous requirement of the law might be fully met in us, who do not live according to the flesh, but according to the Spirit. And so the chains of sin and death are broken. And those chains have been replaced with the Spirit. A Spirit who gives us power to live differently, to live for Christ. And we also experience this glorious hope of eternal life, in which Jesus Christ did what we couldn't do. He paid our price. He broke the doors of hell that we could live forever and ever and ever and experience this freedom for all of time. And I'll close with these words from JFK. He said this: as we express our gratitude, we must never forget that the highest appreciation is not to utter words, but to live by them. So yes, today we say thank you, but if we really want to express our gratitude, both for our veterans, but more importantly for Jesus Christ, that we would live for him, that we would live in freedom, that we wouldn't be bound and controlled by our guilt or by sin or by the law, but that we would live freely for him. Amen. You and to make you know me.